Hi guys, welcome back to Jay's Kitchen. So today I'm going to be making sweet urat porridge. So it's also fondly known in Tamil as ulun kanji. So it's a big favorite in my house. My husband loves this very much. I don't really make this very often, but when I do, I try to make it large batches. So I'm going to be making ulun kanji today, and it has lots of healthy benefits. You should make it every so often because it's really good, really tasty, and also very, very healthy. So my recipe is very simple, but I try to add in some extra stuff to make it more tastier because I'm not a big fan of it. So I need to add in some extra stuff to, you know, get the cake and make me actually eat it. So let's see what are the ingredients we need. So for now, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be showing you the first step, which is soaking the urad dal. So I'm going to be soaking it for about 2 to 3 hours. I don't like to do it overnight, but we're just going to soak it for about 2 to 3 hours. So let's see the process. So I have my urad dal here. So I'm going to soak about 2 cups of this in water. And after 2 to 3 hours, I'm actually going to start blending it, and then we can start the cooking process. So let me prep it and then I'll show it to you. So I've soaked the urad kanji. I've used 2 cups. Filled it up with 2 cups of urad dal, and I've actually soaked it. So I'm going to soak it for about 2 to 3 hours. You can see here it's all soaked. So let's leave it soaking for about 2 to 3 hours, and then after that we'll go for the next step, which is cooking the urad dal. So my urad dal is soaking right now, so it's almost 11. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to soak it for about 3 hours, and then what I'm going to do is while it's soaking, I'm going to prep the ingredients, and we're going to wait, and then after that I'm going to show you how I make the ulun kanji. So we'll see you after 3 hours. So we're back after 2 hours. So my urad dal has been soaking for almost 2 hours, so right now we're going to start blending it into a paste. So this is my urad dal that's been soaking for about 2 hours. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to rinse this and we're going to drain out all the water. So my urad dal that's I've already drained off the water, and it's been soaking for 2 hours. As you can see, it's already like puffed up. So right now we're going to start blending the dal. So I've got my trusted blender here, so I'm going to add in the urad dal gradually, little by little. Since it's a lot, so I'm going to add in like half a blender and blend it. And I'm going to add in water little by little, not too much, because we don't want it to be very liquidy. We just want it to be a little bit of a paste, thick paste. So I'm just going to add in a little bit of water, and then we're going to blend this. Okay, so we blend it to a thick paste. So we're going to take this and we're going to pour it. As you can see, we're going to pour into a separate bowl. Make sure you got all of those out. Okay, and then we're going to blend the next batch. So make sure you've blended everything into a smooth, thick paste. So, and we're going to blend this one. So the undukanji is already blended into a fine paste. You can see here this is equivalent to 2 cups. Like I said, I always make this in batches since I don't make them a lot often enough. So I make them in large batches because I know it'll finish within 2 to 3 days. So now let's see what are the ingredients we need to actually make the undukanji. So these are the basic ingredients we need to make the undukanji. So I have coconut here, grated coconut, which I'm going to be using 1 cup of grated coconut. And then I've got cardamom powder. You can even use cardamom seeds. You can actually blend them together with the undukanji if you want to. So I'm just using the powder. I'm going to be using about 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. And then I have my coconut milk, which I'm going to be using about 2 cups of coconut milk. And you can even use milk, just regular milk. And you can use 2 cups of that. So this one is coconut milk. I'm going to be using 2 cups. And I'm using brown sugar. Jaggery would be the best, but since I don't have jaggery on hand right now, I'm going to be using brown sugar. So I'm going to be using 1 cup of brown sugar. And you can always adjust the sweetness as you require. And you can even use white sugar if you want to. And then I'm going to use about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And this here, ghee, is something that I like to add in a little bit, not too much. Probably about 1/2 teaspoon just for the taste. So I'm going to be adding a little bit of ghee to be included inside the undukanji. So let me prep the ingredients and then we can start making it. So these are the prepared ingredients. So here I have 1 cup of brown sugar, and then of course 1 cup of coconut, grated coconut, 2 cups of coconut milk. It's the whole can. It takes about whole can, a little bit more extra, a little bit of water added in. So it takes about 2 cups. I'm going to add in about 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom, and also about 1/2 teaspoon of ghee later towards the end, and also salt to taste. So for water, don't forget, we're going to start boiling the water. So I'm going to be boiling it first with 3 cups of water, and then we can adjust accordingly because sometimes you don't need too much of water to cook it. So as you can see here, I've got 3 cups that's boiling in a pot here of water. So we've put in 3 cups first. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in my blended undukanji inside this, and I'm going to stir continuously because we shouldn't have any lumps forming. So let's make sure. So we're making sure that we're not going to have any lumps forming in. So we've actually, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to continuously stir it and get it mixed with the hot water, and then stir it until there's no lumps. So this will take some time, so you have to make sure you keep stirring it without actually stopping. You can see it's getting well combined, so just keep mixing it gently. So anyways, the water will evaporate and subside a little bit, so you can just keep gently doing it. So as you can see that the mixture is getting thicker, and I'm using actually a mist, as you can see here, so it's much more easier to prevent those lumps from forming, and it's much easier also for me to actually keep mixing it without getting burned. So you can even use this way because I'm doing like a whole big batch, so a whisk is easier. As you can see, the lumps are not forming. So rather than using the spoon at one point, we're going to be using a whisk. So just continue till the raw smell of the dal goes away. So give it about 10 minutes. If you need to put it on low fire, you can also do that too. Put it on low fire and just keep mixing this. So after about 10 minutes, you can see the urad dal getting cooked a little bit. So at this point, we're going to add in all our ingredients. So I'm going to add in my milk first, coconut milk. And we're going to give it a nice mix because it's already become thick. So gently adding it. mix it together. So make sure that the coconut milk is well combined together to make it like a porridge sort of consistency. Okay, and then we're going to add in our sugar. Then we're going to mix this in. Let's keep mixing it. We're going to mix it gently. If it becomes too thick, you can always add in water later if it becomes too much of a thickness. Okay, once we're done with this, I'm going to lower the heat to medium. I'm going to add in my coconut. And then we're going to give it another mix. I love the taste of coconut when put in. It's so tasty. And you'll definitely love it. It gives some sort of a different flavor to the ulundi kanji. So at this point we're going to add in, since it's getting thicker, I'm going to add in roughly about 1 cup of water. So I'm going to add in 1 cup of water. So as you can see, I've added in 3 cups of water when I was actually cooking the urad dal, and then I've actually added 2 cups of coconut milk, and now 1 cup of water. So totally it all equivalents to 6 cups of liquid. So that's just nice for me. So I'm going to mix it nicely. So I have some of the sugar that hasn't melted yet, so we're going to make sure that we melt everything. So you can even use a whisk if you feel that there's lumps forming. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to get my whisk to help me again. So just before I continue, I'm going to add in my cardamom powder. About 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. That's for the flavor. And then not forgetting my a little bit of ghee. Of course, a little bit of ghee, not too much. You just want it a little bit for the flavor. Maybe a little bit more. Okay, for the flavor. And then of course, some salt to taste. About 1/2 teaspoon of salt. That's it. And then let's get that whisk and start whisking it again. So just making sure that there's no lumps. So this time you're going to be cooking for about 2 minutes until everything is well combined, and 2 to 3 minutes should be good. So we're going to continue doing this until everything is combined. So after 2 minutes, as you can see, my ulundi kanji is all lump free. And it's so tasty. The smell is all over the house, as you can see here. It's thick, not too watery, not too thick, so the consistency is just nice. So after 2 minutes, that's it, we can switch off. And then our ulundi kanji is done. So this is my end result of my ulundi kanji. So as you can see, it's really tasty, really thick. I would not prefer to add in any more water after this, because it's more nicer when you have it like a thick porridge. But of course, you would want to adjust your sugar consistency. So I've added in enough just for us. So you can even add in more if you want to, like maybe when you're eating and you taste it and it's not enough of sugar. So do please add in as much as you need it. Of course, jangiri is better, or brown sugar, rather than using white sugar. So this is it. Please try it, and definitely you have to let me know how it turns out. Please drop me a comment. Hi guys, so I hoped you liked my video on how I made the sweet urad porridge or und kanji. So like I mentioned, don't get shocked at the amount that I make, because I don't really make und kanji very often, and when I actually do, I actually make it in a big batch. And even if I make it in a big batch, it doesn't last me for more than two and a half days. So yeah, so do try and let me know. I know this is something not similar to the regular und kanji, because I add in a little bit of ghee, and also some don't add in coconut, but like to add in coconut. And sugar, please check your consistency and add in according to your preference, because for me one cup is just nice. Sometimes I do add in a little bit once when we're having it, so please go according to your consistency. Try it with one cup of urad dal first and then see how you like it. So if you liked it, don't forget, give me a like on my video. Please share it on your social media and among your friends. And also don't forget, if you're a new subscriber watching this video, please click subscribe. Please support me on all my videos. And don't forget to press the notification bell, so you'll always receive an email notification from my YouTube channel, Hummingbird Mama, whenever a new video is uploaded on my YouTube channel. So thank you. Till I see you on my next video. Have a good day.